Okay, afternoon y'all, this is Renegade Biker 24, and I've got some news so far as my car, and try and get that refinanced is, they told me that basically, I would have to pay an additional, or it'd be like an additional 25% added on to the cost of the loan. And so that would mean that I could go somewhere else and then not charge me 25% on the cost of the loan. Now, it could make the payments lower, or, well, it could make them higher. That's what I found out with the Truity, which is where I was. So, that's what they told me. Now, they said that if I did it that way, I could use that 25% to put it toward the cost of the loan, or keep it and use it for whatever I needed to. Now, that I'm going to look into. I've got the application. So next is right there. That's where this is from, Arvest. So if I can get a good deal, which I'll probably talk to them tomorrow, I could try to reduce the cost of the motorcycle. But I will find out when I do. When I either go to them, either tomorrow or I'll try to go to them, when I go to pay my motorcycle payment, which be right around the 14th. So, but anyway, other than that, I'm also kind of looking forward to my birthday a little bit, but my birthday is in 9 days from this video, which today is September 1st, and the bikes losing barbecue is, I think, September 23rd. That's what I'm finding out right now. I'm going to try and get my birthday off because, well, it's my birthday. So, and what's this idiot doing? Okay, you going to turn right? Yeah. Okay. Now, it is a balmy 80-something degrees right now where I am. So, it's pretty nice weather. I haven't had rain in about a few days because it usually rains at night. So, but it is very, very, very cool. So, that's what's going on. It is nice weather to ride. And I am going to continue to ride to work. With the weather being as nice as it is, I will start riding my bike to work more than my car. At least until things change. But anyway, so that's the big thing right now for me. So I'm saving money on gas, which is good. And the most that I can get out of this bike, I will get out of this bike. It's already got 6,562 miles as of right here. So by the time I get to work, it'll probably be 6,564 or maybe a little more. But anyway, so that's what I'm planning on doing with all this nice weather. See, the guy up there got no helmet, but you know, I guess that's the way he wants it, but you know, that's for a different vlog altogether. But that is about a bait. So, anyway, that's what's going on. A-bait, to me, is a organization that they're the ones that fight for no helmet, no protective gear, nothing like that here. And I find that to be just a downright insulting. As a person that works in a hospital, I see a lot of things, but that is something that I just disagree with. So, but anyway, so I'm hoping I start finding an answer. Which would be good. So we will have to see. Okay. Yeah. We will have to see what happens. So, and anyway, another thing is I am still planning on visiting my nephew this Sunday, because Saturday is going to be quite an experience, because the football Razorbacks are starting their season opener. And that is going to be quite an interesting experience, because when you go through this town, traffic will increase, and it'll be to the point of almost insanity, but no more insanity than over there at the Razorback Stadium, where it seems that if you all do come to any Razorback games at home, which I think Florida's playing here at home, and I think Alabama is, and I think two other teams are, and one of them being Ole Miss, and I can't remember the other one. But I'll find out. So, but anyway, I am, like I said, I am a Razorback fan. And good or bad season, I still support them, even though I think it's a team effort. That's why it's called a team. But some people don't do well with teams, and you'll find that in almost every sport, or even at work. So it's all a matter of trying to get it to where, I mean, the Razorbacks are not top rated, at least this season they're not. And I'm hoping that by the end of this season they will be top rated. But I don't know. I really don't know. I mean, their defense has to improve. Their offense has to improve. And not let their quarterback get sacked a lot. So, but anyway, so that's what I'm thinking about the Razorbacks and how they need to get together as a team and start gelling together and hopefully be number one in the SEC this season. I would like to see them go to the national championship instead of going to some other bowl game. I want to see them go to the national championship. That would be awesome. But I don't know. I really don't know. So, yeah. Come on, people. Okay, it's green. Come on. Come on, people, it's green. Come on. Come on, let's go. Stop texting. Stop texting. Okay. This is insane. People are still texting while driving. So, okay, come on, people. Alright, now we're getting somewhere. Anyway, this is what I mean by getting insane here. This traffic, this is just insane. But like I said, I'm hoping that the Razorbacks do good this season. I would like to see them beat Florida instead of Florida beating down on them almost on a constant basis. I would like to see them win against Florida this year. So, their first game is Saturday, and I will post their opponent in the description box, because right now I can't even remember, but I think it's UTEP. So, and that's what I think their opponent is. So, I'm hoping that the drama of the Razorbacks is behind them. I really am, because that was insane. The drama being Houston Nutt was fired, and there was a big old to-do about him. And I'll go into that in a different vlog. But it all started with what I call the Springdale Mafia, and that is five people that had gone to the Razorbacks. One was Mitch Mustaine, and we all know what happened to him. He's a joke. And then there's Damian Williams, and then there's Ben Cleveland, and I think there was another guy. And then, of course, there was Gus Malzahn. And Gus Malzahn was supposed to be the best coach and so far as Arkansas is concerned. But he wasn't a head coach. He was just an offensive head coach. And somehow, some way, there was a big old to-do about that, which in turn brought on the Bobby Petrino bill, where Bobby Petrino had his little motorcycle accident with a girl from the volleyball team. She had an affair, and that's what happened there. But anyway, well, it's Renegade Biker 24, and I'm here at work, so I will talk to you guys later.